Hello friends, today we are going to study meaning and process of research in detail. Following steps we are going to study in detail. Please watch my video till end because you will find different examples for each and every steps we are going to study in detail. Business research is a process of acquiring detailed information from all business area and using that information to maximize business sales and profit. This study helps companies determine which product or service is most profitable or most in demand. Step number 1. Formulating research problem. Problem clearly stated is a problem half solved. The first and most important step in research is the formulation of research problem. It is like the base of a building to be built. To solve a problem, someone needs to know about the problem. Therefore, the identification and formulation of the problem is very crucial for the researcher before conducting a research. And this is perhaps one of the most difficult aspects of any research enterprise. The researcher needs to refine the topic and clearly state what is intended to be explored on the topic. The formulation of research problem basically includes narrowing the research data and formulating the objectives. Once the research problem has been formulated, the topic is ready to be subject to scientific investigation. For example, as a public health student with the intention of working with HIV/AIDS patients, a researcher may want to conduct research in an area relative to HIV/AIDS. Step number 2. Literature review. A literature review is a comprehensive summary of past research on a topic. The literature review searches from academic articles, books, and other sources relevant to a specific area of research. The review should enumerate, describe, summarize, objectively evaluate and clarify that previous research. It must provide a theoretical basis for the research and assist researcher in determining the nature of research. The literature review recognizes the work of previous researchers. It is assumed that when mentioning a previous work in the field of study, the author has read, evaluated and assimilated that work. For example, a book that examines the history of the Israeli-Palestinian conflict may include a chapter on the role that Egypt played in mediating the conflict, or browse the index for pages where Egypt is mentioned in the text. Step number 3. Development of hypothesis. A hypothesis is a specific prediction about a new phenomenon that must be observed if a specific theory is accurate. Hypotheses are developed by considering existing evidence and using reasoning to infer what will happen in the specific context of interest. There is no correct number of hypotheses to consider. The number depends on the nature of the analytical problem and how advanced you are in analyzing it. A simple hypothesis is a prediction of the relationship between two variables, the independent variable and the dependent variable. For example, how does the amount of makeup one applied affect how clear the skin is? Here, the independent variable is makeup and the dependent variable is skin. Step number 4. Preparing research design. After formulating a research problem, researcher will have to prepare the research design. That is, researcher needs to declare the conceptual framework within which the research would be carried out. Decisions on what, where, when, how much, and by what means of research constitute a research design. It helps researcher to be as efficient as possible with maximum information. It is a plan for data collection, measurement, and analysis. A good research design must be flexible, appropriate, efficient, and economical. There are different types of research design available. Explanatory research focuses on why question. For example, it is one thing to describe the crime rate in a country, to examine trends over time, or to compare the rates in different countries. It is quite a difficult thing to develop explanation about why the crime rate is as high as it is, why some types of crime are increasing, or why the rate is higher in some countries than in others. Step number 5. Determining sample design. All items under consideration in any field constitute universe or population. The complete inclusion of all items in the population is known as census. But this type of investigation requires a lot of time, money, and energy. Therefore, we can select only a few items from the universe. The selection item constitute sample, and the way sample is selected is called sample design. A good sample design must represent the population and must be viable in the context of cost. The sample must be such that the result can be applied to the universe with a reasonable level of confidence. For example, researchers plan to select only 20 out of 200 cities drugstore in a particular way is called sample design. Step number 6. Data collection. Data collection is the process of collecting and measuring information about targeted variables in an established system, which allows researcher to answer relevant questions and evaluate the results. Data collection is a component of research in all the field of study, including physical and social sciences, humanities, and business. There are two types of data, primary and secondary. Primary data are collected afresh and first time through survey, experiment, and interviews. Secondary data is data that has already been collected through primary source and made readily available for use by researchers. The researcher must select one of these methods, taking into account the nature of research objective, the scope of the investigation, the financial resource, the time available, and the degree of precision desired. For example, research on online review of customer in which customer writes about a product and answer to an open research question about what type of video a consumer likes to watch online and the conversation a customer had with a customer service representative. Step number 7. Execution of project. If the execution proceeds on the correct line, the data to be collected will be adequate and reliable. The research must be carried out systematically and over time. If the survey is conducted by question, the data can be processed on the machine. If interviews are conducted, interviewers must be selected and trained accordingly. Occasional field check should be made to ensure that interviewers are carrying out their work with sincerity and efficiency. For example, a criterion such as the adequacy of facilities and equipment may be required for a project that requires sophisticated laboratory techniques but would be largely irrelevant in a desk study. Step number 8. Analysis of data. Data is collected from various sources related to your research topic. After the data is collected, it is reviewed and analyzed to reach a conclusion or form some kind of discovery. Data analysis is the process of evaluating data using logical and analytical reasoning to carefully examine each components of the data collected or provided. In business terms, data analysis play an important role where it comes to making decisions that involve some kind of risk or uncertainty. For example, to forecast next year's revenue, data from previous years will be analyzed. If revenue goes up 20% each year for many years, we will predict that next year's revenue will be 20% higher than this year. Step number 9, hypothesis testing. It is a statistical act in which the researcher tests an assumption about a population parameter. The methodology used by the analyst depends on the nature of the data used and the reason for the analysis. Testing hypothesis means trying to determine whether the hypothesis is valid or invalid, whether it is accepted or rejected. Various tests such as the chi-square test, t-test, and f-test were developed by statistics. If a researcher had no hypothesis to start, generalizations are established. For example, researchers think that if patients suffering knee problem undergo physical therapy twice a week instead of three times, then the recovery period will be longer. The average recovery time for patients undergoing knee surgery is 8.2 weeks. Step number 10, generalization and interpretation. If a hypothesis is tested and maintained several times, it may be possible to reach generalization, that is, to construct a theory. Interpretation means bringing up the meaning of data or converting data into information. Interpretation is useful, as the usefulness and utility of research result are in the proper interpretation. It helps to establish concept that may be useful for future researchers. For example, if you want to improve a program by identifying its strength and weaknesses, you can organize the data into program strength, weaknesses, and suggestions to improve the program. If you want to fully understand how your program works, you can organize data in chronological order in which customers go through your program. Last step, preparation of report. Finally, the researcher must prepare a report of what was done by him. The report layout consists of number 1, preliminary page which carries title and date followed by acknowledgement, list of contents, etc. Number 2, main text which includes introduction, summary of finding and recommendations, main report with logical sequence with result and conclusion of report, etc. Number 3, end of report includes bibliography and appendix. For example, raw data and calculations, interview questions, a glossary of terms, or other information that the reader may find useful to refer. All appendix should be clearly labeled and referred to where appropriate in the main text. Friends, thank you for watching my video. If you like my video, then please subscribe to my channel Management by Dr. Mitul Dhimar and share my videos.